Come, take a ride back in the Wayback Machine with me to the 1980s and 1990s when people talked a lot about the ozone layer.
The ozone bubble surrounding the Earth helps make life possible on this planet by screening out harmful ultraviolet rays. But there is a new warning tonight that depletion of that ozone layer by man-made chemical gases could cause a health catastrophe here.
In the years since then, America stopped talking about the hole in the ozone and appeared to have forgotten about the fact that it was a catastrophe. It was a huge deal, and then it was just sort of gone from conversation, like Garfield or Chips Ahoy. That is, until this week, when we got some very good news. That hole in the ozone, it's finally on the mend. After more than three decades since scientists first discovered a hole in the planet's ozone layer, leading experts backed by the United Nations said the layer is on its way to full recovery. As it turns out, making the ozone the pressing global crisis of a generation was a good thing. In 1987, 46 countries signed a treaty known as the Montreal Protocol, and they agreed to phase out dozens of synthetic chemicals that were commonly found in things like refrigerants and hairspray, chemicals that were tied to the destruction of the ozone layer. That treaty now has nearly 200 signatories. And the result is clear. If current policies stay in place, the ozone layer is on track to recover by the year 2040. Global action to solve a major environmental problem worked. And now, in the year 2023, we can look back on those choices we made in the 80s and the 90s and the early 2000s and know with certainty that they were the right ones. At least most people think so. Most people who aren't still weirdly stuck in the 1980s.
In the old days, you put the hairspray on, it was good. Today, you put the hairspray on, it's good for 12 minutes, right? But, you know, they say that you can't. I said, wait a minute. So if I take hairspray, and if I spray it in my apartment, which is all sealed, and you're telling me that affects the ozone layer? Yes. I say, no way, folks, no way.
Way, way. And as it turns out, the hole in the ozone is healing. Other catastrophes, however, continue.